You got it.
I never experienced such a thing.
Finish it.
You feel like you're dying.
It's called the Elevation Training Mask. Those who use it, like NFL receivers Kealoha Polaris and Greg Salas, along with UFC veteran Max Holloway, have labeled it the Mask of Misery.
What it does is it restricts your breathing. So it is a next level training in the sense that if you're not in good shape already, you probably shouldn't even try to put that gas mask on.
Scientifically, its purpose is to condition the lungs by creating pulmonary resistance, thus strengthening lung stamina, oxygen efficiency, and perhaps most importantly, increase overall mental focus under fire.
You know you're not going to go through anything tougher than that. You got to be able to tell yourself, I got to push through this. You really have to concentrate on, not only finishing your reps, but breathing.
Sometimes you hit that wall and you're like, you can't do it anymore. You got to pull it off and just get a little fresh air.
You got to battle yourself. It's you. It's yourself with that mask on. And it's a crazy experience.
Now, specifically for Holloway, the mask has added importance as the UFC featherweight's next fight is in the thin air of Denver, Colorado. And one of the mask's primary targets is to mimic the effects of high altitude.
I think this will help me out a lot, The whole time I'm just telling myself the fight's not going to be this hard.
And with all of its intense intangibles, don't downplay the aesthetic advantage of looking like a straight-up superhero.
Definitely, gas mask gives them a little bit of bravado. Yeah?
I'm a Call of Duty fan, so I love playing Call of Duty, so I think I'm just about to go to war. I
almost look like a serial killer in one of those crazy axe murdering movies.
It does look a little funky. Take pictures while you can, because I guess it does look sick on Instagram.
The mask gets put to the test later this summer. When both Salas and Polaris report to training camp on July 28th, Holloway will fight Justin Lawrence on August 11th. Rob DeMello, KHON2 Sports.